The dock connector on the iPhone 3G and 3GS is responsible for so many things. So if you're having problems with your microphone, lower speaker, antenna, or dock connector, oftentimes the problem can be solved by just replacing it. Hi, I'm MJ with iFixit, and today I'm going to show you just how easy it is to replace your dock connector yourself. It'll take you less than an hour, and it costs way less than buying a whole new phone. This video is just an overview, so as I repair this iPhone, I'll try to give you some tips on some of the trickier parts. And while it's not a very difficult repair, the iPhone 3G and 3GS use different dock connectors, so make sure you order the right one. And of course, follow the step-by-step instructions in the repair guide on our site. As far as parts and tools go, you're going to need a small suction cup, a paperclip, a plastic spudger, a Phillips 00 screwdriver, which I got from our 54-piece bit driver kit, and your replacement dock connector. I'm also going to use a screw tray, which isn't totally necessary, but it helps me keep all the tiny little screws organized. Now that I've got all of my parts and tools together, I can get started. First things first, I'm going to remove the SIM card using my paperclip, or an official SIM removal tool, if you have one. And once that's out, we're going to remove the two screws down by the dock connector with our screwdriver. After I've got these out, we're going to use that small suction cup to take the display off. Okay. Once the display is loose, you don't want to go yanking this off right away because it's still held to the logic board with a couple of cables. So I'm going to use my spudger to disconnect those, then I can take the display assembly off. Now that I've got the display assembly off, there are a few screws to remove and a few more cables to disconnect before I actually get to remove the logic board. So I'll go ahead and take care of those now. Before I remove the logic board, I'm going to gently pry up the camera out of its housing. And once that's free, I can just use my spudger to go along the bottom of the logic board down by the dock connector and kind of pry it up and slide it out of the phone. Now that I've got the logic board out, we can see the dock connector, but we can't remove it just yet because there's still a few more screws to take out. So I'll go ahead and remove those. With those last screws removed, I can take out the old dock connector. I'm just going to use the end of my spudger to kind of loosen the microphone out of its housing in the frame. And when I put this new one in, I'm going to make sure that the screws in the dock connector assembly actually go in above the screws in the bezel. Otherwise, the dock connector doesn't line up in the bottom, and you'll be able to tell that just by looking at it. All that's left for me to do now is reassemble my iPhone, and I'm back in business. Of course, you can find all the parts and tools for this and many other repairs at iFixit.com. And if you run into problems during your repairs, there are lots of solutions in the iPhone 3G and 3GS repair manuals on our site. Thanks for watching and happy repairing.